This is Rata Super, and this is another DeviantArt review. If you're new to one of these videos, I'm not here to tear anybody down. I'm here to give positive reinforcement and also constructive criticism. Now, I always say with criticism, if it makes sense to you, you know, process it, keep it. If it doesn't make sense, then just leave it behind. I know every artist has their own stylistic views on the world, and one point of view isn't necessarily more correct over another one. Now, if you want to be featured in one of these, all you have to do is comment on my page or send me a note. The link to both myself, my art page, and the artist being featured will be placed in the description. The artist being featured today is Lucci2508. And the very first thing I noticed about this artist was their chibi style, how kawaii or how cute it is. And I know that's not necessarily a style for everybody, but I know I really enjoy the style, and that's one of the reasons why I started watching this artist, was because of that. And I chose this particular piece to talk about because of its aesthetic nature. I just really enjoy looking at the colors in this. I really enjoy the shading in this also. I think overall it was a good representation of the quality of the artist's work. You know, I honestly wouldn't have anything to criticize about this. And I will mention, I appreciate that the artist always puts a background in their stuff. That's really important, especially in digital artwork. Let's go ahead and move on to the next piece. Again, the use of backgrounds in her work is really well done. This is simplistic, however, I think it's effective in setting the atmosphere. All it is red in different tones, but I think it really helps the piece, and it really helps the foreground character stand out. Now, I wasn't sure if the artist was forgetting to color in the space between the background and the foreground character, and that's why this hard white outline is there. But the more I looked at the gallery, I think that was just a stylistic choice that the artist made. It works in some places, and in this one, the only thing I would criticize is that the background need to be filled in here between the legs, the coat, and the arms. Now, that could, you know, relatively nitpicky, but I think it would have helped it if that place would have been filled in with red. But other than that, this is really good. Alright, let's go ahead and move on to the next one. Now, one of my favorite things, and probably the reason why I started watching this artist to begin with, is the fact they combine their kawaii, their cute style, along with darker, spookier stuff. And I think when that's done, it creates something interesting. This one, again, it has those aesthetic colors. I think that this particular character, because this isn't necessarily true of all the art that they do. Sometimes the colors are a little bit more dull and flat, but I think this particular character is always in the aesthetic style. And the shading on this is really well, and I really enjoy the background. I like how it goes from dark to light. This gives it a more creepy feel. The only thing I might criticize about it is the fact that hands are hidden. It does look good, though. This piece looks good, but again, I always appreciate when the artist shows the hands, simply because of how hard hands can be to do. Alright, let's go on to the next piece here. Now, this artist really does gifts well, and I really like gifts. I like personally making gifts, and I really appreciate a gift in an artist gallery, because it definitely shows an understanding of motion and elevates what may be a simplistic piece to something much more interesting to look at. And as you can see, this GIF is cycling through, having the character do basic animation and changing it up, which makes it, you know, very interesting to look at. Again, I enjoy this artist gallery. I enjoy the chibi style. I enjoy the colors that the artists use, and I especially appreciate the fact that the artists always make sure to include some type of background in their work. I know that's it sounds like a simple thing to request for an artist to do in the background. However, it definitely shows an artist's creativity. Even if the background is extremely simplistic, it's still the background itself, in my opinion, could be featured as a deviant or artwork, simply because it does take time and effort to put in there, especially to make it look pleasing. Alright, this is Rata Super. Again, I hope you enjoyed this review, And the links will be in the description down below. Rata super out.